Hi, my name is Tristy, and welcome back to the 30-day Mean Stack Challenge. I'm just going to start up Grunt, and let's just get the app up and running, and we'll look at what we created. And today we'll extend that out a little bit further by continuing to work on this page. So this is what we created in the previous video. Today we're going to jazz this up a little bit and. Where we've actually just mentioned icon, we're going to add in the actual glyphs in that place. So let's do that. So we'll start off with icon over here. When we look at the wireframe for what we want to create, we'll continue using Bootstrap because Bootstrap actually has a whole heap of glyph in a font format that we can just bring in and use. Now, if I'm brand new to Bootstrap and I've got no idea how to do buttons, the best place to start is on the Bootstrap website. If I go across to CSS and just jump down, just make that a little bit bigger, just go down to buttons. I can see that Bootstrap already has a series of buttons for me. So the button that I want, the first one that we want to create was this green button with an image of a user on there. So to do that, I can just copy this code here. So I can just grab that and bring that over, plug that in. I don't actually want to have any text in the middle. What I want is that image of that user. So to do that, I'll just go I class, and the class that I want to set up to find the right glyph, I just go across to components, and I can see there's a whole heap of glyphs here that are already for me, and one of the first ones is this one for user. So just copy everything. So glyphicon dash user, grab the whole lot, put that into the class, and close that off and close off that tag. And we just jump down to the next one. Now for this one, when we look at it, we see that the text next to this button is actually nice and quite big. So we'll make that H1, so make that heading tag. Move that into that text, so within the H1 tags. And we see that this down the bottom where it says total customers, that's a bit of a muted kind of color, and Bootstrap also has a class for that. So we'll just put that into a span class, and we're looking at text muted. And I'll just grab that and paste that into there. So let's have a quick look at our handiwork. So I'll just save that. We see that Grunt's constantly looking at this file, and every time I make changes, it's just restarting for me. And there we go. So at the moment, I've got something that looks like this, and there's you can see that the button's a little bit out of alignment with our text. Our text is nice and big because that's now got the H1 tags around it, and that one's changed color slightly. Because it's now got a bit of a muted color, but I'm not really happy with this. Now, how do I know what's going on here? And the best way for me to identify it, if I'm using Chrome, just make that a little bit bigger. We can go across to Tools and just go to Developer Tools. And if I just now just right click on that text and just do an inspect. So you can have a flick through here and just have a look at all the CSS that's actually been applied to that style. So there are a couple of ways that I could make this button move down and align with the H1 tag. One way is actually to create some custom CSS, but I'm going to go with the lazy way, and that is just by putting this button in H1 tags. So we'll just go H1 and just grab that, put that at the bottom, and indent that one just so I've got my nice neat alignment. And again, I'll save that, and I should now see that the same attributes that were being applied to the text should also be applied to the button. So there we go, we've got some alignment kind of happening here. All right, so now we just need to move on and do that for all of the other icons. And I'm going to show you the long way in this particular video. And in the next one, what we'll do is actually apply a bit of Angular magic, and look at how much code we can get rid of when we apply Angular. So let's go through the long way, but we will have a shortcut soon. So I can actually just kind of copy these pieces of code down here, and I just need to change the icon. So I just show you the icons that we've got. That's calendar. Throw that into H1 tags. So this is a bit of a test for you too. If you want to pause the video here and just go through and try and do this yourself, it'll just give you a bit of practice. This next one I know is edit. This one over here now. So this one we've got what they call a record. Keep moving on. So this one is what they call eye open. And this last one is just a flag. Last H1 tag. Span class. Text muted and copy that in. All right, so let's have a look at that. Hopefully, we're starting to see something that looks a little bit more like this. Okay, so one thing that we'll notice here is that everything is green, which isn't quite like what we wanted over here. So when we look through this, we can go back to our buttons and just see that we've actually used the word success for all of these, right? But actually they're not all, we don't all want them all to be green. We want them to be different colors. So I've just jump back to CSS and I'll show you there's what the code is for the other colors. So we can just go to buttons again. So the darker blue is primary. The lighter blue is info, and then the orange is warning, the red is, so let's do that. So this one is, so coming back here, so the darker blue is this one here, so that's our primary. Then we have success again because we've got that green. We've got this lighter blue, so that's info. We've got this kind of orangey color, that's warning. And then we've got our red at the end, and that's danger. Okay, so one more look at that. All right, so let's have a look at a couple of things while we're at it. So this background here, we see it's still quite white. But the color here is a little bit more of a kind of a grayy kind of color. And the way that we can change that, we'll just change the body. So we'll see that in the modules, each module has a whole set of different folders. And we've been looking at views and we've been looking at the home client view. But if we go into CSS, we see that there's a CSS file that's actually been already kind of set up here for us. Now, in order to change this background, across the board, what we want to do is add in a body color. So it's quite straightforward. So we just want to change the background color. Oops, not background attachment. Background color. And we can change it to anything we like. So for example, I could just change that to gray. But the cool thing that I like about WebStorm is it actually has this sort of color picker. So I could just grab that, come over here, identify the same color that is, which is just heaps of ease, and choose that as my body background. So again, when we see that come up, we've seen now that that's got that sort of grayish color that gives us that similar look that we've got here. We see that at the top we've got app makers. And here we've got MENA. Ours is dark, whereas this one is sort of kind of this clear see-through kind of color. So again, if we look at bootstrap and we go across to all the way up here and go across to components. See, Bootstrap has this thing called nav bars, and they're essentially the navigation bars that are at the top. And you can see that if I wanted a nav bar that was this kind of lighter gray color, what I need is a nav bar with a class of nav bar default. Whereas if I wanted something that was a bit darker, see, which is the one that we currently have in the app, we've got this nav bar inverse. So if you wanted to change that, where do you actually find that in your app? I can show you where that is. That's actually the hook in from the server side to the app itself. So it's actually up on the app side. So it's up in the views. So we go to app, we go to views, and we're going to go to layout. And we see in layout that these are all the things that create the head of the app and point to where the body kind of kicks into the app itself. And this is how our app connects down to our Angular app, if you like. So here we're actually saying that we're going to include this header client view and bring that into our app. And when we're doing that, we're going to push in this navigation bar. We've fixed it to the top and it's an inverse bar. Now we're going to change that to default. So that's easy. Just kill that. Start up Grunt. Now while Grunt's starting off, the next thing I'm going to do is go to public modules view, so where we were before, but this time instead of going to the home client view, I'm going to go to the header client view. And if you go down to line 9, you see that we've got this nav brand, and the nav brand is the equivalent of what we've got up here on our mock-up. So I want to change that to app makers to be similar to our mock-up. So I've got that there. So save that. So now, when I've got my mock-up up here, when I go and look at the actual app, so let's have a quick look at the mobile version. So if we go back to our app and we make this a bit smaller, bring that in, we see that we're starting to get that same kind of format happening for the app itself. All right, so that's it for this video. Thanks very much. Please subscribe to the channel and check out bossable.com for more details. Thanks again.